And now it's time for another podcast from Pastor Dan Smith. Coast to coast, city to city, border to border, he's live on the air. Good afternoon, good evening to each and every one of you. Glad you guys are a part of our podcast tonight. Tonight we're going to be talking about some things that's been heavy on my heart for quite a while, and that is making sure people are ready to go when Jesus returns. And so what does it mean to be born again? Well, let's start with prayer before we get into it, okay? We always want to invite everybody to our church, Connect Church, great place, community of believers. We are located at 1417 Herbert Street, South Roxanna, Illinois, 62087. Our worship time is at 10 a.m. on Sunday. We have worship and praise. We have children's ministry. And we also have a nursery that is available for you and your family. So we hope that you'll come out and be a part of that. We're looking forward to growing our school. We do have a Christian school here from preschool four-year-olds all the way up to 12th grade. And so we want to encourage you to check us out there. You can reach us at either phone number at area code 618-254-1308 or 618-254-0188 and ask about the church or the school on either one of those lines there for the phone. So we encourage you to be a part of our community of believers, be a part of the hands and feet of Jesus as we reach this community for Jesus Christ. And we hope to see you this next coming Sunday. So what does it mean to be born again Christian? Well, let's start with prayer. Father, we thank you, Lord, for this day. We thank you, Lord, for your blessings. Thank you, Lord, for this time that we could get together and do this podcast. We thank you, Lord, for each one that is joining us this evening. We ask your blessings be upon them. We ask, Lord, that you open our hearts and our minds. And Father, Lord, that we'll share this podcast with others. So Lord, we pray for that. We ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen. We want to encourage you to make sure that you let people know that the podcast is available. It is available on YouTube. It is also available on Apple, and it's also available on Spotify. And it's called Wednesday Night in the Word. Wednesday Night in the Word. So if you know somebody that needs Jesus, I hope that you will share this podcast with them. What does it mean to be born again Christian? Well, the classic passage from the Bible answers this question in John chapter 3, verses 1 through 21. It says, there was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. This man came to Jesus by night and said to him, Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher come from God, for no one can do these signs that you do unless God is with him. Jesus answered and said to him, most assuredly I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus said to him, how can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter a second time into his mother's womb and be born? Jesus answered, most assuredly I say to you, unless one is born of water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Do not marvel that I said to you, you must be born again. The wind blows where it wishes, and you hear the sound of it, but cannot tell where it comes from and where it goes. So is everyone who is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus answered and said to him, how can these things be? Jesus answered and said to him, are you a teacher of Israel and do not know these things? Most assuredly, I say to you, we speak what we know and testify what we have seen, and you do not receive our witness. If I have told you earthly things and you do not believe, how will you believe if I tell you heavenly things? No one has ascended to heaven but he who came down from heaven, that is the Son of Man, who is in heaven. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so the Son of Man must be lifted up, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. He who believes in him is not condemned, but he who does not believe is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. And this is the condemnation, that the light has come into the world, and men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. For everyone practicing evil hates the light, and does not come to the light, lest his deeds should be exposed. But he who does the truth comes to the light, that his deeds may be clearly seen, that they have been done in God. The Lord Jesus Christ is talking to Nicodemus, a prominent Pharisee and a member of the Sanhedrin, which is a ruling body of the Jews. Nicodemus had come to Jesus at night with some questions. As Jesus talked with Nicodemus, he said, "I tell you the truth, no one can see the kingdom of God unless he is born again." "How can a man be born when he is old?" Nicodemus asked. "Surely he cannot enter a second time into his mother's womb and be born." Jesus answered, "I tell you the truth, no one can enter the kingdom of God unless he is born of the water and of the Spirit. Flesh gives birth to flesh, but the Spirit gives birth to the Spirit. You should not be surprised at my saying, you must be born again." The phrase translated "born again" can also be translated as "born from above." Nicodemus had a real need. He needed a change of heart, a spiritual transformation that only could come from above. New birth, being born again, is an act of God whereby eternal life is imparted to the person who believes. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new." Titus 3:5 says, "Not by works of righteousness, which we have done, but according to his mercy, he saved us through the washing of regeneration and the renewing of the Holy Spirit." In 1 Peter chapter 1 and verse 3, it says, "Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who according to his abundant mercy has begotten us again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead." In John chapter 1, verses 12 through 13, indicates that being born again also carries the idea of becoming children of God through trust in the name of Jesus Christ. The question logically comes as this: why does a person need to be born again? The Apostle Paul in Ephesians chapter 2, verse 1 says, And you he made alive who were dead in trespasses and sin. To the Romans, Paul wrote, "For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God," in Romans 3:23. Sinners are spiritually dead. When they receive spiritual life through faith in Christ, the Bible likens it to a rebirth. When he says sinners are spiritually dead, whether you've accepted Jesus is the key here. You have to accept Jesus to go from death to life. People who have not accepted Jesus as of yet today are walking dead people, spiritually speaking. They are dead in sin. In other words, they will be separated from an almighty God. That's why they need to receive spiritual life through faith in Christ. And that's why the Bible likens it to a rebirth. Only those who are born again have their sins forgiven and have a relationship with God. Twice in his conversation with Nicodemus, Jesus stressed the truth that one must be born again to enter the kingdom of God. Being born once makes us children of Adam, and we share Adam's corruption. We need a second birth, a spiritual birth, to make us children of God. We must be born again. How does the new birth come to be? Well, Ephesians chapter 2, verses 8 and 9 states, "For it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from yourselves, it is the gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast." When one is saved, he has been born again, spiritually renewed, and is now a child of God by right of that new birth. Faith in Jesus Christ, the one who paid the penalty of sin when he died on the cross, is the means by which one is born again. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has gone, the new has come." If you have never trusted the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior, will you consider the prompting of the Holy Spirit as he speaks to your heart, even right now during this podcast? Ladies and gentlemen, you must be born again. You have an opportunity right now in this day of grace that we live in. Jesus has not returned yet to receive the church. The rapture hasn't taken place. Rapture, by definition, means a sudden catching away. That has not happened to the church yet. So there is still grace that abounds here. You have the opportunity, the easiest opportunity now, to be saved. You need to be born again. Will you pray a prayer of repentance and faith and become a new creation in Christ today? Ask yourself that question. In John chapter 1, he says this, "Yet to all who received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become the children of God, children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision, or a husband's will, but born of God." Have you made a decision for Christ in your life, ever? If not, we invite you to pray this prayer and believe it in your heart, your mind, and your soul. Would you pray with me? Dear Lord Jesus, I know that I am a sinner, and I ask for your forgiveness. I believe you died for my sins and rose from the dead. I turn from my sins and invite you to come into my heart and life. I want to trust and follow you as my Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name, amen. If that's the prayer that you prayed and you believed it in your heart, your mind, and your soul, please contact us at 2connectchurch.org or by Facebook Messenger at Connect Church, and we would love to send you a free book, free of charge, postage paid, on your next steps with Jesus Christ. We want to say once again, thank you for joining us on this podcast. This podcast is important to share with others. Please share it with your family and friends, neighbors and coworkers on what they must do to be born again. Time is short. Jesus is at the door and we'll all be taken away someday very soon. So please share this on YouTube, Apple, or Spotify. Please share Wednesday Night in the Word, this podcast, on this May day, okay? We appreciate that. So thank you for coming, and we look forward to seeing you next week.